Book Library. We are back again for kids yoga. Hopefully everybody's been doing great, and I can't believe we are in the month of September. So in September, my kids and I like to go to lots of farms. We like to pick maybe some apples. Do you like apples? We like to pick pumpkins. Sometimes we see animals like horses and cows and sheep and pigs. So today I thought it would be fun to do a farm-themed yoga. Does that sound good? Okay. So what we're going to do first is I need everybody to pause the computer or run real quick and get yourself a stuffed animal. Any kind will do. If you don't have a stuffed animal, that is fine. But you're going to take your little stuffed animal and you're going to lie down on your towel or your mat and put your stuffed animal right on your belly. And as we lay here, I want you to breathe and your animal will rise up and fall down. You're going to do that for 3 breaths. Can you do it for 3 more breaths? Let our animals go up and down and take a little ride. Ready? Go. Excellent. Okay, let's sit up back into our pretzel pose or crisscross applesauce. We'll put our friends off to the side. And I want to sit nice and tall, and we're going to breathe our arms up, breathe in, and out. One more time, breathe up, and out. Good. Breathe in, and out. Excellent, excellent. So sometimes when we're walking around the farm, we see little insects flying through the sky, and they're actually really, really good because they help to pollinate all the flowers so that our fruits and vegetables can grow, our flowers can grow, and they make a buzzing sound. Do you know what insect that might be? You're right, a bee. So what we like to do is something called bee breath. So you're gonna sit up nice and tall, take your hands, put them on your knees, and we are going to make bee sounds. Do you think you can do that with me? Good. So let's breathe in through our nose and out like a bee. Good. Do it again. Breathe in and out like a bee. Good. Let's do our bee breath one more time. Wake up our body so we are ready to go on our farm trip. So put your legs out in front of you. I don't know if you guys can see that on the camera. Out in front of you, we're going to wake up our feet. So we're going to do our feet point down and up. Down and up. Good. Let's wake up our knees. One knee up. The other knee up. The other knee up. The other knee up. Awesome. Let's wake up our arms. Rise up to the sun and down. Other arm, rise up to the sun and down. Both arms up to the sun and down. Good. Let's roll our heads to the right and to the left. Excellent. Great job. So I think our bodies are warmed up now. So we're going to do something we've done before, if you've been with me, it's called the sun salutation. And this is our way in yoga to thank the sun for all that it does for us, okay? So I'll go slow the first time and show you all the parts, and then we're gonna put together some music, okay? So stand up nice and tall, and the first pose of our sun salutations is mountain pose. So mountain pose, you put your palms out, legs out wide, hip width, and you're looking up into the sun, okay? Then you put your hands together and you're gonna burst up like a volcano. So we're gonna burst up to the sky. Good, that's volcano pose. Then we forward, flap down. And you just let your arms hang. Then you hold your shoulders and we can rock the baby. Rock the baby back and forth. Back and forth. Good. Then take your hands and we're gonna put them in front of us. And we're gonna lunge back with one foot. Lunge back with the other foot. And you're gonna stay in that plank for 1, 2 seconds. Good. Belly will hit the ground. Chest will hit the ground. You're gonna push yourself up like a snake. Can we make the snake sound? Good job. Tuck under those toes and pop up, downward dog. You can wag the tail if you want. Wag the other tail if you want. And walk back up to the top of your mat, back into mountain pose. Okay, so let's do this to music. Here we go. Mountain pose. Good. Ready to get your mountain poses? Here we go. Mountain pose. Hands together. Good. First up with the volcano. And forward, flap down.
Visions, but only illusions.
Your hands and put them in front of you. And step one foot back. Stretch there. Step so both feet back. Good. Belly down. Push up.
I know we're wrong. Wait and see.
Good. Tuck under. To read our book for today. Okay, our book for today is called Apples and Pumpkins by Anne Rockwell, illustrated by Liza Rockwell. Now, a fun fact is that Lizzie Rockwell, is Anne Rockwell's daughter. So her mom wrote the story and her daughter drew the pictures. Isn't that pretty neat? Okay, so let's read Apples and Pumpkins.
When red and yellow leaves are on the trees, we go to the Comstock farm to pick apples and pumpkins. Mr. Comstock gives us a bushel basket to put our apples into. Geese and chickens and a big fat turkey walk with us on our way to the orchard where the apples grow. All the animals? My father picks apples. My mother does too. I climb into a little apple tree and pick the reddest apples of all. What are your favorite apples? There are red apples, there are green apples, there are yellow apples, so many to choose from. When our basket is full of red and shiny apples, we go to the field where the pumpkins grow. I look and look until I find the best pumpkin of them all. My father cuts it from the vine. I carry it back to the car. Oh, that must be heavy. Home, we carve a jack-o'-lantern face on our big orange pumpkin. We put a candle inside and light it. Now our pumpkin looks scary and funny too. On Halloween night, we put our pumpkin on the doorstep. My mother gives away lots of our red and shiny apples for trick-or-treat. While I go trick-or-treating up and down our street. Believe it or not, Halloween will be coming soon too. You have to start thinking about your costumes. Excellent.
Enjoyed reading Apples and Pumpkins. All right, who would like to play a game? Okay, we're gonna play a game called Farmer Says. So everybody come onto your mats, put your legs straight out in front of you. And let's hop onto our tractor and see if we can find any animals at the farm. Okay, so we're going to touch our toes and pull back. Touch your toes and pull back. Touch your toes and pull back. Touch your toes and pull back. Shh. Okay, we are here at the farm, so let's stand up. All right. So we're gonna play Farmer Says. So if you've ever played Simon Says, I say Farmer Says, be a horse. And you're gonna do a horse pose, okay? If I say Farmer Says, be a cow, you'll do a cow pose. If I just say, be a mouse, don't do it because Farmer didn't say, okay? But first I'm gonna teach you the poses. So the first pose will be, we're gonna do cat and cow because they go together. So we're gonna go on our knees, put our hands in front of us, okay? And you're gonna curl your back up like a cat. Meow. And then put your belly down and look up, and that's a cow. Moo. So do cat and cow. Good, okay. Next will be a mouse pose. Sometimes there's little mice scurrying around the farm. So you're gonna go down into our mouse pose. So we're gonna be in tiny as a ball. So come on down on your knees and you can put your hands in front of you and curl up and just stay right there with your head down. Or you can take your arms around and grab your feet and go all the way down. And that will be quiet as a mouse. Okay, horse pose. If I say farmer says horse, you're gonna go down into your downward dog. You already know downward dog, so that's dog pose. And then we're gonna put one leg up, like a horse's tail. And that is horse pose. Good. Okay, so we'll start with those. I also might say duck, duck. We're gonna go down like this in a squat. And then you just put your feathers out like this. Okay, all right, so let's start. Farmer says. All right. Farmer says, cow. Remember what cow is, you're gonna go down, right? And look up, belly down, woo. Ready to do cow pose. Farmer says cow. Good. Farmer says dog pose. There you go. Good job. Horse pose. Oh, farmer didn't say. Farmer says cat pose. Let's come back down all fours and curl up that back. Farmer says mouse pose. Let's go down in a little ball. Farmer says horse pose. There we go. Up and downward dog and stick up that tail. Good. And up. Farmer says chicken pose or duck pose. Let's go down in a squat. Wings out. Can even walk. Mouse pose. Oh, farmer didn't say. Farmer now says mouse pose. Good job. Awesome. All right, let's hop back on our tractor. And we're going to go apple picking. Let's go. So touch your toes and back. Touch your toes and back. Touch your toes and back. All right, let's go look at all those apple trees. I think we're gonna pick a lot of good apples and maybe we will make some apple pie with that. So let me change our song here. All right, let's do the apple tree dance.
Other class.
La, 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 la. So let's try that tree pose one more time. I know that came as part of our song, but we can be an entire tree growing. So let's go down as a seed. Good. And then we're gonna slowly rise up our roots. Up, up, nice and tall, good. Now take your right foot, put it by your ankle, and you'll go slowly up with your branches, up. Good. If you would like to try, you can bring your foot up a little higher to your calf. Awesome. Shake it out. Good. Bring your feet together and try the other side. So we're going to put our hands together. Left foot by your ankle. A little higher if you want. And then you're going to go up, 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 up with your branches. Awesome job. Good. All right. So it's time for our cool down. So everybody lie on your mats, on your backs. Okay. So you're gonna lie back on your backs. If you still have your stuffed animal from earlier, you can put it on your belly again, or you can just hold it cozy, okay? And I want you to lay down and close your eyes. And I want you to imagine that we are on a magic carpet. And we're flying overhead. Still stay laying down with your eyes closed. Just listen to my voice. And you're on your magic carpet, and we're beginning to lift off, and fly over the farm that we just were playing in. And you look down below, and you see the apple trees, and the sunflowers, and the cows, and the pigs, and the chickens. And you can wave to them from up above. You're up so high that you feel the sun on your face and you feel the wind blowing as you're flying through the air. And it's so relaxing. And then we get a little bit closer to your house. So we float overhead and we start to come down slow. And whoosh! Let's land in your living room or in your room. And when you're ready, you can turn to your side and push up with your hands and come back into your pretzel pose or crisscross applesauce and sit up nice and tall. And let's do one more breath in. And let's do that bee buzz out. Good, let's do one more. And buzz out. Good, let's do one more big sunflower up. And down. Good. Let's reach out to the side and give yourself a big hug. And out again real big. And reach and hug yourself again. Great, 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 great job. At the end of every class, put our hands together and we say peace and love. Be you and have a great, great week and a great month. And I will see you again for our Halloween themed yoga in the second Friday of October. Okay, until then, namaste. Thanks for joining. Talk to you soon. Bye, everyone.